everyone, and welcome to Lety Does Altered Carbon. Alright guys, so the second season of Altered Carbon has come out, and I saw season one, like, a long ass time ago, and I really liked it, but I feel like I'm with the general, like, consensus of people who liked it, and then since there wasn't anything for 2 years, it's just like, don't really remember it. I saw the recap for season one, and I mean, I remember the general plot, but all the details of all the twists and turns of surprises and stuff, I'm gonna need refreshing on that. I feel like more than likely it's gonna show me right away in the first episode and stuff. like what exactly happened. There's probably gonna be another recap in the beginning and I'll watch it, but yeah. I don't know. So basically, for those of you that haven't seen Altered Carbon, it's about this man named Takashi Kovacs. And he is part of a, as far as I remember, anti-government group who are against the usage of stacks. And basically those record your brain and your personality and just who you are as a person, and they store it inside of a small disc that goes into the back of your neck, inside of your spinal cord. So, yeah, they are against the usage of that because they say that's basically immortality and it's inhuman. So, ironically, the leader of this group is the person that made them, and now they regret having ever created it. So basically, all of them are living on this remote island trying to plan when they just get raided, and in all of the pandemonium, they don't really fight them off well, actually. And in the getaway plane is Takashi's sister and what's her name? Quinn? Quell? The previously mentioned woman who created the stacks, who's also Takashi's lover. And they accidentally leave Takashi behind because of so much craziness going on. He stays behind to fight them as a foot soldier. And he's happy for a moment that they managed to get away, but then the ship blows up. And Takashi then gets, put into government custody. He gets imprisoned for 250 years before a rich man, decides to give him a new sleeve and asks him to be his investigator on who murdered him. So that kind of goes on, as, well, not a side thing, but that's the reason that we get to see Takashi again. He becomes Joel Kinnaman, and he goes around looking into who killed this man, and at the same time that that's going on, he's also been getting, like, some weird, cryptic messages, I guess. And it turns out that it's actually his sister that's been trying to communicate with him. And his sister is alive because she backed herself up to the cloud before the explosion. And it turns out that her sister had not wanted to be a part of the group, that she had been working with the government, and that she was the one that blew up the ship previously mentioned. So, yeah. She and Takashi do not get along because of that anymore. And it ends with Takashi basically killing her. He does finish his mission that he was given, but since he didn't accept the guy's initial terms, I think now he... I don't remember if his debt is completely paid and he's able to go free, or if he's just agreed to continue working with them. In any case, he's still around. But the surprise for this season was that it is no longer Joel Kinnaman, but rather Anthony Mackie, who's going to be playing him, which is pretty great because, you know, this is kind of like a more futuristic, grosser Doctor Who. Definitely grittier. But the method of becoming a new person is they literally, like, birth them. It's, yeah. Anyway, so Anthony Mackie, no idea what this plot is going to be regarding for season two, because his sister is dead and all, but they did leave open the possibility that his ex-lover is alive, so we're gonna see that. But yeah, I'm still foggy on all the details. This was literally 2 years ago. I am just excited to see it again because it was a really cool show and it was really pretty, and yeah, I really liked the characters and everything that was going on, so I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm gonna watch it anyway. And that's basically where I'm at. Altered Carbon, Season 2, Episode 1, Phantom Lady. Let's get started. Is that Poe? Oh, yay! I loved Poe! Keshi Kovach? I beg your pardon. Kovach. That's how you say it? They had a thing. Poe's just like, don't you dare reduce this! This is love! But I mean, if Poe is there, that means that he can hear everything anyway. Oh yeah, all of a sudden, he doesn't introduce himself in English, huh? Aw, this lady is just trying to sing and everyone's being annoying. Yeah, well, I don't like being interrupted either. It's not like you were gonna say- Aw, Poe is like his sidekick now? So first he got cross-sleeved and then he has this, like, super soldier sleeve. I don't want to see that image. Oh no, I hate that part! Oh no! But he didn't kill all those guys. Those guys were already dead when he got up. What the hell is going on? Night and stars in their orbits. There was a yes or no question, Poe! Fucking Poe, man. I love Poe. He's the best. We'll have to return their colonel now. No war. No reason to stay. Oh man, I just noticed this guy's tie. I was like thinking about her shoulder pads, but that guy's tie though. Colonel. Well, I think you're giving them too much credit. Look at it!
You twice. Oh. Are we there yet?
Oh no! Poe frequently doesn't remember, but he just keeps telling him.
The emitter. Perhaps I can assist in negotiating this misunderstanding.
No! Leave him alone!
You're a dead man.
Damn, dude, you just got this sleeve. It's all fucked up already.
Your understatement hasn't changed. Has anything else?
Wow! You're just bagging on that guy. Yeah, he's really fucking disappointing. Aw, he's tired of his bullshit.
That's all there is left.
So he keeps Poe around to make sure that there's someone to answer him when he talks alone to himself, but clearly it looks like without Poe, he'd still talk to himself, so... Whoa, what is he doing? What are you doing? Oh no, come on. Okay, I get it, stop. He's losing so much blood! Alright, so... I am so intrigued right now, so... Kel is definitely alive. Or new, whatever. She's around. He's not crazy in that sense. But I do love the fact that Takashi just, he's carrying Poe around. like he's a dysfunctional smartphone. He's just like, it's okay, Poe. I just told you 3 times, Poe! I'm sorry, remind me again. Oh, amazing. How he just needs to keep being reminded. Oh my gosh. You know what's a little disappointing, though? I would have liked to see him in the sleeve of the singer that the episode opened off with a little bit longer. Like, that looked so cool, and I want to know what happened there. Like, what were you doing that you needed to be put in the sleeve, and then he's obviously still doing missions, and then what, he just decides he wants to part-time as a singer, like... I wanted to know, but that quickly went away. I did like to see the transition though. That was cool with him turning into Anthony Mackie. I thought that those effects looked really cool, and oh man, I don't know. They threw so much in here this first episode. I liked the fight scene. It was a little fast, so we couldn't see like all the movements, how choreographed it was, but there were some, you know, cool things in there as well. But yeah, I guess this season is picking up on where in the world is Kel, because he's been looking for her the entire time. So, I don't know. We're just gonna have to see. But anyway, sorry. Yawning. Anyway, what I was saying was, all of this was just so interesting and pretty, and I have high hopes for this season. I'm pretty excited. Of course, you know, we started off the season with another full-grown adult artificial birthing scene, and he needed to take the tube out of his throat, and everything looks so pretty, very cyberpunky. But anyway, let me know what you guys thought of this episode, and if you guys were excited for this season. And that's basically all I got for you for now. So get out there, do all the stuff, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
Hey everyone, Lety here. Just trying on another outfit for my Winter of Workout Wear try-on haul, February 2020. And if you want to see me work out while wearing this colorful soccer outfit, then you can go ahead and vote for it by checking out that video down there. Bye!